Hey everybody, what's going on? It's your man, Kohrey. Welcome to the Digital Dash, where I'll be giving you guys tips on how to market your songs and get those numbers booming. Now, for those of you who don't know who I am, I'm a digital marketer myself. I specialize in helping artists like you guys get their songs heard through platforms like Spotify, Instagram, YouTube, and a bunch of others. Now, what I want to talk to you guys about today is how you can create omnipresence. Now, what exactly is this? Omnipresence is defined as the state of being widely encountered and widespread. Basically, it means that you're everywhere all the time. A good person to think about this is someone like Drake. Whenever he drops a new release, it feels like he's literally everywhere. He's on every single magazine. He's being talked about in every single media outlet. He's on every single playlist. It feels like you literally can't escape him. He's everywhere all the time. That is omnipresence. Now, if you have the budget and resources to do so on a larger scale, I definitely recommend going for it. But for most of you who are just starting out, there's definitely a way that you can do this on a much smaller scale with a much smaller group of people and start to feel like you're everywhere all the time to them. So with that being said, I want to give you guys three tips that you can start to use to create omnipresence amongst a small group of people. Now, one of the first things that you'll want to do is figure out where exactly your fan base lies. So figure out where they like to go to be entertained, what types of things they like to do, so forth and so on. The better understanding that you have of your fan base, the more you're able to realistically look into your resources and your abilities and start to figure out how you can get in front of these same people. So let's say, for example, that you know that your fans like to read Pigeons and Planes. They may like to follow certain fashion and skateboarding pages on Instagram, and they like to watch certain sneaker YouTubers on YouTube. So you may stop and say, I don't have anyone that can get me on the Pigeons and Planes, but I'm able to reach out to these Instagram pages that talk about skateboarding and fashion and figure out how I can get them to post my content. I'm able to reach out to this YouTuber and get them to do a reaction video to my song or put my song underneath one of their videos. Doing so will give you the chance to potentially hit the same person over and over again through different mediums and types of content, causing the illusion of omnipresence to that person and making them want to actually go and check you out because they keep seeing you everywhere. The second thing that you'll want to do is to actually engage with relevant communities. Now, this is a lot easier to do on social media because you can just interact with people in the comment section. So Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube will be the easiest ways that you can go about doing this. So what you'll want to do is to actually engage with fans underneath the comment sections of relevant influencers to your brand or to relevant niche pages that make sense to your potential fan base. Now, make sure that you're engaging with these people in a relevant way that actually brings value to the community. No one likes it when someone just hops into the conversation and blatantly promoting themselves and their music. You don't want to be that guy, trust me guys. The third thing that you'll want to do is to actually create relevant media for these relevant media channels. Now, you want to make it look as natural as possible so that these fans don't feel like they're being marketed to, but it just so happens to feel like you're being everywhere to them all the time. So let's say that you're hitting these different niche pages on Instagram. You want to actually create content that makes sense for that actual page. So if they're posting memes, you want your song attached to a meme. If they're talking about cars, you want your song attached to cars. And if you're going to be using influencers, then you'll want to make sure that your content makes sense with the types of contents that they usually make, all while actually being impactful upon their audience, giving them a reason to actually come back and check you out. Now let's take Drake again as an example and use the time that he and Ninja played Fortnite. Now, Drake didn't just go into Ninja's Twitch channel and start going, hey guys, listen to my song, but he actually played a game that was very relevant to Ninja's audience and gave those people a reason to check for Drake just outside of music. Now, once it was over and everything was all said and done, if you were a gamer, it felt like Drake was everywhere. He was being talked about by all of these different gamer YouTubers, different Instagram pages and Facebook pages that talk about gaming content, were reposting things that had to do with him, and relevant media and press that talk about gaming related news were covering this event. So Drake was definitely very omnipresent within the gaming community after he played this game with Ninja. So like I was saying, try to create relevant content for these relevant media channels so that you make it look as natural as possible to the audience that you want to target. All right guys, so just to give you all a little recap, tip number one, figure out where your audience goes to be entertained and to get the information. Tip number two, engage within relevant communities and interact with people who could become your next potential fan. And tip number three, create relevant content for relevant media channels and try to make it look as natural as possible. Now as always guys, if you feel like you learned anything today, please like and share this video. Hit those post notifications as well, as I wouldn't want you guys to miss anything. Once again, my name is Kohrey and I'll see y'all next time.